Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to explain what a set is in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you wouldn't mind, please like, comment, and subscribe. One like equals one prayer for the YouTube algorithm. A set is a collection which is unordered as well as being unindexed. They do not allow any duplicate values. For example, let's create a set of silverware. So in order to create a set, we need a name for this set. Let's call it utensils equals. And in order to create a set, we need to surround all values with a set of curly braces. Now let's add a few utensils to the set called utensils. Let's add a fork, a spoon, and maybe a knife, and that should be good. And let's display all of the values. For x in utensils, print x. Now, with sets, they're different from lists because they're unordered as well as being unindexed. If I were to print all of the elements in utensils, they might not necessarily be in the same order in which we placed them. For example, when we printed all of the elements found within utensils, first we had a knife, a fork, and then a spoon. If I were to run this again, they might be in a different order, kind of like that. So a set is actually faster than a list if you need to check to see if something is within a set compared to a list, and they do not allow any duplicate values. Let me add a bunch of knives and let's see what happens. So I'll have a total of 3 knives, but when we print all of the elements of this set, only one knife appears. So here's a few useful methods of sets. The first method is that we can add an item to our set. So type in the name of the set. In this case, it's utensils dot. And here's a bunch of methods that you can use. I am looking for add, and we can add an element to the set. I would like to add a napkin. And then if we were to print the set, we do have a napkin within the set. We can also remove an element, utensils.remove. And I would like to remove the fork. And now our fork is gone. We can also clear, utensils.clear. And all of the elements within our set should be gone. So let me turn these lines into a comment. All right, for this next example, we'll need a second set. Let's create a second set called dishes. And then we need a set of curly braces. And let's add a bowl, a plate, and a cup. Our next method is that we're going to add one set to another by using the update method. Let's say we would like to add our dishes set to our utensil set. So let's type utensils dot and use the update method. And within this method, we will pass in the set that we would like to add. So utensils update dishes. This will add all of the elements found within dishes to our utensil set. And you can see that when we print our utensils, we have a bowl, a plate, and a cup in here as well. And then if I were to switch these around, let's say dishes update utensils. And then I will print everything found within dishes. Now there's a fork, a spoon, and a knife in here as well. We can also join two sets together and create a new set entirely. So let's create a set called dinner table, like we're setting up a dinner table and we need a fork, a spoon, a knife, a bowl, a plate, and a cup. So we have a dinner table set. We're going to set this equal to either utensils.union dishes, or we could do dishes union utensils. Either way would work. And let's display all of the elements found within dinner table, and we should now have elements from both sets, utensils and dishes as well. There are also some methods in which we can compare the similarities as well as the differences between the elements found within two sets. Let's say I would like to check to see what utensils has that dishes doesn't. And for this example, I think I'll add a knife to my dishes set, just so that they have at least one thing in common. So I would like to see what utensils has that dishes doesn't. So we can do so using the difference method, and I will print the results with a print statement. So I'm going to compare utensils against dishes. Utensils dot difference dishes. And this will print what utensils has that dishes doesn't, which is a fork as well as a spoon. And we can reverse the roles too. We could say dishes, difference, utensils. What do dishes have that utensils doesn't? And dishes has a cup, a bowl, and a plate. They both have knives, so that's why knife isn't appearing. We can also check to see if there's anything that they have in common using the intersection method. So I'll turn this line into a comment. We'll print utensils dot intersection dishes. And this will return whatever element that they have in common, which is a knife. All right, everybody. In conclusion, a set is a collection which is unordered as well as being unindexed. They do not allow any duplicate values, and you can do things like compare two sets, see if there's anything that they have in common, any differences, and we can add or remove elements to a set. If you'd like a copy of all this code, I will post all of this in the comments down below. Don't be afraid to smash that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro. Hey you, yeah I'm talking to you. If you learned something new, then help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.